I usually do the honors.
Not today, Cha-Cha. I was born for this moment. Listen up, ragamuffins. I will not allow Riverdale High's above average GPA to suffer because of classrooms that are overcrowded with underachievers. So please, do us all a favor and find some other school to debase with your hard scrabble ways.
Why don't you come over here and say that to my face?
Happily, Queen of the Buskers.
Okay, guys.
Did you just tell Jughead that Archie and Betty kissed?
Yes.
So what if I did? Did you at least have a reason?
Oh, that's right. You're new here. Hi, I'm Cheryl Blossom, aka Cheryl Bombshell, which means I need no reasons. I simply am. Feel free to tremble.
I have a better idea. Why don't you tell me what's bothering you? Because clearly, you're in a lot of pain.
Get your sapphic serpent hands off my body!
Let me guess, some cherry cola for Cheryl Bombshell.
My God, what do you want? And why do you keep stalking me?
I'm not. I came to see this movie with Fangs and he bailed on me. Are you okay?
I'm alone at the movies. And I'm trying to stay away from my mother who has turned our house into her sexual playpen. So no. I'm really not.
Well, I was gonna go grab a seat alone. Unless you want some company. But no pressure.
Everyone thinks I'm this loveless monster. But it isn't true. I loved someone. Who loved me. My mother destroyed it.
Cheryl, I am so sorry. But you have to know your mother's wrong. You're not loveless. You're not deviant, okay? You're sensational.
What is going on in here, Cheryl?
Mrs. Blossom. Hi, I'm Toni Topaz. I'm a friend of Cheryl's from school, and she's lending me an outfit for the will reading.
And why on earth would you be there?
I invited her to be my emotional support. In honor of Toni joining our squad, I think we should celebrate with a mandatory slumber party at Thistle House. He didn't want to invite all the girls tonight, but I knew my hideous mother would never allow me to invite just you, which is I craved.
You're not alone. Together we stand. I'll be
I didn't just bring you to Thistle House for a girlish slumber party. The truth is, I'm terrified of being alone here. There's a stranger in this house. My Uncle Claudius. He's as mad as the sea, and ever since he blew in, I feel like I'm in mortal peril.
Wait, I'm confused. Is this real, or are we playing a game?
All too real. TT, I fear they're plotting against me and Nana Rose. He's wearing my father's pajamas.
What?
My uncle. Toni. I think they pushed my Nana down the stairs. I think I'm next.
So far away, I wish you were here. Before it's too late, this could all disappear.
There you are, looking a little worse for wear. Poor dear hasn't slept in days. Why don't we stop bothering Dr. Masters and I'll take you straight home. Come on.
You've gone mad. That's all there is to it. You have lost your mind and you leave us no choice.
What do you mean, no choice?
But it's all right. We're gonna make you all better.
Awesome. Hi. I'm looking for Cheryl. She wasn't at the hospital with her Nana.
No, she's gone. Boarding school in Switzerland. All girls. She left just last night.
Mrs. Blossom, that doesn't make any sense.
Don't come here again.
Oh, you poor child.
There's nothing to be afraid of. Sister Woodhouse is going to help you.
Thank you, Sister Woodhouse.
Yes, she's going to rid you of all those naughty demons. The ones making you think such awful, unnatural thoughts.
Her mom said they sent her off to some all-girls boarding school in Switzerland.
Well, that's easy enough to check. There's only one. Cerval Montreux.
Please. If Cheryl was on the Swiss Alps, she'd be posting parka selfies every hour.
But her social media has been dead for days.
Wait. That's a sure sign of foul play.
Whatever you need, Toni. I'm in.
But foolish girl, what have you done? You stacked the bags in the northeast corner when I specifically told you the northwest.
What? No, you said...
Start over.
Hello?
She's not far away.
Who is this?
Cheryl. She's nearby.
When we get to the main building, what happens then?
We search each and every damn room until we find her.
Rescue you.
You don't?
Now that you're free, what's your first move gonna be?
Well, Toni, if revenge is a dish best served cold, my mother and Uncle Claudius better brace themselves for a polar vortex. here I'm back just in time for Carrie the Musical, which you're directing.
You are. And I'm having auditions this afternoon.
Well, as far as the lead role's concerned, cancel them. I'm obviously Riverdale High's Carrie White.
Matter of your safety, I have to recast the role of Carrie.
I will not succumb to thespian terrorism and allow myself to be ousted from this production. After the fires I've walked through, Kevin, the world needs to see me up on that stage.
This matricidal revenge fantasy? Never gonna happen. That's final.
I just wanted to prove to everyone that I'm still me, but maybe I'm not. Toni, even Carrie White could stand up to her mother.
Hey, Cheryl, you gotta show your mother who's in charge.
I don't know if I can anymore. I'm not the same girl who burned down Thornhill and cut off her oxygen.
Sure you are. You're not done playing Carrie, Cheryl. Not by a long shot.
You run whilst you still can. I only miss when I mean to.
We need to talk. All of us.
There's nothing to talk about. I'm taking Toni and we're leaving.
Not so fast. I've been waiting to see you again for a long time.
Get back, you hobgoblin.
I brought backup too.
That jacket looks good on you.
Everything looks good on me.
Well, maybe we should make it official.
In unrelated news, for the foreseeable future, all former Southside High students will remain at Riverdale High.
I'm retiring from the Serpents. For real this time. Whoa. And my boy has never stopped fighting for this crew. Hell, he almost died for it. That's why I'm giving you the mantle. Now is your first official duty as Serpent King.
Think you know what to do with this?